today we are going to be talking about character and the science of character and how our thoughts and our internal drive really do dictate our behaviors and the choices we make. Obviously, we are really going to be pushing for you having positive character and good character and making great character choices. And that's what our topic is going to be actually for the rest of this week. So today is going to be talking about the science of character, why it's great for you, why you should be really pushing to make sure you understand that character is important. And then we are going to end with watching an 8-minute video. This one you do have to watch. Your reflections are going to have to be based off of the video. And then also you're going to be taking a character survey. All right, so please make sure you got your understanding stuff on, and you might have to refer to Schoology as well as this video. Today we're going to talk about what character is, why it matters, and how can you develop some positive character traits. So first of all, character. The motivation to do what is right. The decisions you make, the emotions you have, and the thoughts that you think when no one is around. So when someone isn't there to tell you what's right and wrong or to influence your thoughts and your behaviors, what's your gut instinct? What we need to understand first is there is a huge difference between reputation and character. Your reputation is what other people think you are. And as you know, as well as I do, that there are a lot of people out there that they behave in one way when they're around certain people, and then they get behind closed doors and they act a completely different way. And typically it's not as positive. So there are plenty of teens out there who have what we call success in their lives because maybe they're great at their activity. They might have a ton of friends and maybe they do really well in school, but deep down they have pretty poor character. Because just being good at stuff and having a lot of friends or getting good grades isn't all it takes to be successful. For example, you could be really good at your activity, your sport, your arts, whatever it might be, but maybe you yell at your group if they make a mistake. So also, maybe you have a ton of friends and right there you're like, well, I'm fine. But at the same time, you lie to them just to get what you want so you can manipulate. And lastly, you do really well in school. School is not hard for you at all. But if you do get anything wrong, you immediately blame the teacher or someone else for your mistake. So you can be great at things and also have poor character. So you need to make sure if someone does talk to you about your character, or if you do talk to someone else about their character choices, you can't have the attitude of, well, if it works for me, it must be great for everyone else around me, because that's extremely selfish. So having poor character leads to people resenting you, even if they stay friends with you, because especially at this age, we don't typically dump our friends. So what you need to do is find the balance of working on positive character, but also make sure you consider your reputation. Do they match? So the student on the left, he tells me, well, I'm gonna snap that kid from math class who I know has a rough time at home. So I wonder how they're doing during the quarantine. And that same kid, when he's at lunch with his classmates, he says, did you see how they left their tray on the table and said, I don't care, the custodian can pick it up. What a jerk he is. So he's able to recognize poor character in other people, even though they're his friends, but he also is making great character choices. So his character and his reputation match. So to tie it back to our top 20 teens curriculum, top 20s make choices that build their star qualities or their great positive character traits, because their decisions today are truly going to build their character for the future. So be a bright light wherever you go. So this doesn't mean you're perfect. It doesn't make that you make awesome decisions all the time, because you know what? That's really hard. But it does mean that people can trust that you're always going to try to do the right thing. And if you do make a mistake, you're immediately going to fix it. So we're going to watch an 8-minute video that shares the science behind character. And it's going to prove that we can shape who we are and who we want to be in the world.
There are 7 billion, well actually 7.1 billion humans on the planet. And each one of us has a unique character.
So what determines your character?
you do and all the people around you. And of course, some genetics too. But there's new science proving that if you focus on certain parts of who you are, you can develop your character and ultimately live a more meaningful, successful, and happy life, no matter what your circumstances. I mean, isn't that what we're all trying to figure out? This whole idea about developing our character really took shape in 2004, when two psychologists suggested that instead of just focusing on all the things that can go wrong with us, it's also important to celebrate all the things that can go right. You see, they looked throughout history to identify core virtues that humans across cultures have agreed lead to a meaningful life. And then they identified 24 character strengths that, when practiced and developed, could lead to these virtues. And they organize them, like scientists have done throughout history to understand things better. These groundbreaking studies showed that every person is a unique combination of these strengths. Like for me, I'm high on curiosity, I could work a little on the prudence. Actually, what is prudence? Anyhow, one of the most interesting parts of all this is they found that if we focus on building upon the strengths we have, it has a lasting effect on our happiness and well-being. So think about it. What are your top five strengths? Now, another part of this is that you can help shape other people's character too. They found that the key to human relationships is ultimately appreciating the character strengths in others. To explore this, we asked people around the world, who do you admire and why?
I admire my mother the most because she's very loving and caring.
She shares целеустремленными людьми, которые готовы бороться за свою цель.
The person I admire the most is Einstein, of course.
My sister, because she is so tough and so brave.
People who use their creative energy to make the world a better place.
This powerful new framework paved the way for a whole new era of social science that, it turns out, is unpacking a very old idea. So how do we develop these character strengths? One theory suggests that people either have a fixed mindset or a growth mindset. A fixed mindset is the belief that we're born with certain abilities, intelligence, and talents, and we're stuck with it. A growth mindset is believing I can change. If I set my mind to it, I can do anything. Let's take, for example, failing at something. With a fixed mindset, failing means I'm a failure. A growth mindset understands failure happens to everyone. Of course, it's hard, I've been there, but it's also something to learn from, something to improve upon. Fortunately, we can all develop a growth mindset. It takes practice and it takes encouragement from the people around us, but it can be learned. And it's all because of an amazing part of the human brain called the prefrontal cortex. It's like our brain's control panel that orchestrates our thoughts and actions. What many scientists call executive functions. Or what neuroscientist Adele Diamond calls self-regulations. I like to think of it as my self-control filter, the thing that keeps my impulses and emotions in check. And the way to strengthen that filter is as simple as taking a moment, focusing your attention, and asking yourself, is what I'm about to do a reflection of who I am and who I want to be? So while we're all becoming more and more distracted in this age of distraction, we need to remember to take a moment and think. There are a lot of new exciting conversations happening about character. One that I find interesting is that there are seven strengths in particular that can be real game changers in academic achievement, success, and happiness, no matter what your circumstances. Those seven are optimism, gratitude, social intelligence, curiosity, self-control, enthusiasm, and perseverance, also known as grit. While there have been many different theories about character throughout history, what scientists in this field agree on is that character matters, and that character strengths can be learned, practiced, and cultivated. So when you think about yourself, what are your strengths? And how can you find ways to use them more in your home, work, school, and community? It's like you have these superpowers, and focusing your attention on them makes them stronger. And then, if you focus on the people around you and their strengths, it makes them stronger too. As each of us becomes our best versions of ourselves and encourages others to do the same, we can lead to important changes throughout the world. Just imagine a world infused with more humanity, justice, courage, wisdom, and compassion. So if you can be a better version of yourself, how do you want to be?
I definitely want to be somebody that other people can feel they can rely on.
A man who was courageous.
Somebody who went for their goals.
A risk taker.
Kind.
Exactly like my mom. Beautiful, strong, and powerful.
I want people to say that I'm funny.
Who is a nice person.
Musica.
Generous.
Be yourself.
Kind.
Accountable.
Incondicional.
Ama ni chaya de la mosi.
También sensible. Apasionada.
Carismática.
I want to become someone who, when the time comes for me to die, I go, oh my goodness, I have boosted up. I have wrung it dry.
Everybody is a star. They just need to learn how to shine.
Character strengths are. So you're going to take a character strength survey. You're going to watch the video, and there's how to get through this. So you can fast forward through some of it if it makes some sense to you, but you do need to make sure you're following the steps in the video. It's about 90 questions and it takes about 10 minutes and it does go quickly. So when you're answering the questions, though, please make sure you go with your initial gut response. Don't overthink it. Don't try to have the quote unquote the perfect answer. Do your best to stay out of the middle. We don't want to be neutral on a bunch of this stuff. So even if you're not proud of it, you probably can choose one side or the other. Then you're going to turn your three screenshots into Schoology, and to find out what your screenshots are, you need to watch the video.